Hi, I'm Hannah Bartram, and I work at UC Davis in the lab of Professor Pam Ronald. Today I'll be telling you about the work we do in plant genetics in the lab. First of all, you might be wondering why we care so much about plants. The world's population is growing quickly, and we need to feed everyone without further destroying the environment. Biotechnology is one tool that scientists use to reach this goal, allowing scientists to develop crops with resistance to diseases and crops with higher vitamin content. By improving the crops with genetic techniques, we can successfully grow more food on the same amount of land. In this lab, we specifically focus on rice, which is a staple food that billions of people depend on. Today we'll be showing you how we genetically transform rice using a technique called tissue culture, where we use bacteria to insert genes into the plant genome so we can study them. This is a powerful tool that allows us to run experiments looking at specific molecules in the rice to figure out what those molecules do for the plant. Let's go visit Dr. Flora Erkley in the lab to see how we actually do genetic transformation.
Hello, I'm Flor. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at Bamson Ronald Lab, and today I will be showing you one of the most common methods used for rice transformation.
The most common methods used for rice transformation utilizes a bacterium called Agrobacterium tumefaciens. We use this bacterium to transform plants because Agrobacterium has the natural ability to transfer its own DNA into plants. In this case, we're making transgenic rice plants by integrating a piece of DNA called tDNA transferred from the bacteria into the plant's genome.
First, we need to introduce our gene of interest, shown here in pink, into a DNA element called a plasmid that we engineered into the bacteria. Then we'll put the bacteria in contact with a mass of rice cells, and the Agrobacterium will take care of transferring the gene we are interested in into the plant through its own natural process. Then, from that mass of cells, we grow plants that hopefully have specific traits that we are looking for because of the genes we inserted.
The plants we are showing today are genetically engineered to have higher levels of a molecule that we hypothesize has a role in making the rice plant immune to disease. Modifying the amount of this molecule the plant makes is one way we can test this hypothesis. By doing this genetic transformation, we modify the rice to cause an observable change, a phenotypic change, in the plant that can be linked to the molecule's function in disease resistance. In our transformation protocol, we start with mature rice seeds. First, we grind them up in order to remove the outer husk of the rice grain and reveal the seeds inside. We place the seeds in tubes and sterilize them in order to eliminate any microorganism growing on top of the seeds. Then, we grow them in a special gel called a culture or growth medium, which contains certain chemicals that will start the process of growing a mass of cells called a callus. We will work with this calli for our transformation. The calli grow in the incubator for 9 days. Next, we infect the calli with Agrobacterium and let them shake for half an hour. Then, we scour the extra bacteria and dry the calli. We'll transfer them to a petri dish and let them grow for a few days in the darkness at room temperature. This gives the Agrobacterium time to transfer its DNA into the plant. We will continue the transformation process, allowing the calli to grow on a new medium in the incubator. While the calli are growing, we start a selection process. During the selection process, only the calli that actually receive DNA from the Agrobacterium are allowed to grow. Some of the cells didn't get transformed by the Agrobacterium, so we will throw those away. This is what is called a positive selection. We only keep the calli we are interested in. But how do we know which plants to keep during the positive selection? The genetic differences are not visible to the naked eye. We actually took care of that when we infected the cells with the Agrobacterium. The piece of DNA that the Agrobacterium transferred to the rice cells didn't just have the gene we are interested in, it also had a selection marker gene. The medium the calli are growing in has a special chemical in it, which means that only the calli that receive the selection marker, and therefore the gene of interest, are able to grow in the media containing the chemical. After 10 days on the selection medium, not all of our calli have survived. Notice that some of the calli turn brownish, while the others remain creamish. The creamish colored calli are the ones that remain active, alive, and they will be subsequently transferred to fresh selection media. We'll do this at least two more times, allowing the positive calli to keep growing. After we finish the selection process, we continue with the regeneration, which is when the callos becomes a rice plant. This is possible because this media contains a combination of plant hormones that will induce this process. The regenerating shoots are finally moved to a media that allows root to develop, and then the plant is ready to be moved to the greenhouse to complete its life cycle and produce seeds. The seeds harvested from our new plants will be grown and analyzed to see if we can observe differences compared to a non-transgenic plant. In this case, we transform the plant with a gene that we suspect makes it resistant to disease. Next, we will infect these engineered plants with the bacteria that cause the disease and determine whether they get sick. We hope our hypothesis gets confirmed and the gene we added helps keep the plant healthy. Ultimately, developing healthier plants means farmers can grow more food for the world.
Thank you for joining us today. I hope you enjoyed.